Here in the U.S., the Supreme Court is taking on the contentious issue of same-sex marriage today. It's hearing four cases wrapped up into one big case. And as Paul Strand reports, that could lead to a ruling that might suddenly make gay marriage legal in all 50 states.
The Supreme Court is dedicating at least 2.5 hours to this monumental case, not the usual one, and all for one big issue.
The only thing before the Supreme Court is, will they force all states to have same-sex marriage?
The stakes couldn't be higher, with the court possibly determining the very nature of what marriage is.
Regent Law Professor Brad Jacobs says gays and their allies see marriage as an institution that brings with it certain exclusive benefits.
And they look at that and say, well, it's just discrimination to not allow a couple that consists of two men or two women to have that same privilege of having that kind of relationship.
Traditional marriage advocates see it as the millennia-old sanctioning and blessing of men and women uniting, producing children, and giving them a mother and a father. Leading traditional marriage advocate Ryan Anderson.
Same-sex marriage sends a signal that mothers and fathers are interchangeable, and therefore mothers and fathers are replaceable. It'll be very hard to say that fathers are essential if the law has redefined marriage to say fathers are optional.
Another huge issue, should citizens in the states decide this most fundamental matter, or federal courts?
The Supreme Court case is going to determine whether or not citizens or judges get to define what marriage is in the 50 states.
It's been primarily something that states controlled in their sovereignty.
Kathy Roos of the Family Research Council.
And the law in this case is clear. States have always had authority to make marriage policy decisions.
So this is a really big constitutional question concerning the powers of the federal government and the state government.
Historically, the citizens and our elected representatives got to make marriage policy. Now we have the chance that 9 unelected judges are going to redefine marriage for the entire country.
But one thing this case is not about is the Supreme Court banning gay marriage. Even if the court rules it should be left up to the states, it's already legal in 37 of them. Though in some of those states, because judges ordered it.
There's no outcome of this case that would make gay marriage go away. States will continue to consider it. Some states will adopt it. At least for the present, some states won't.
The Supreme Court shouldn't cut it short. We should let the discussion continue. Let the laboratories of democracy do their work. We don't need the Supreme Court settling it once and for all 50 states.
That's what the court thought it did with Roe v. Wade. Yet 42 years later, abortion still fiercely divides the nation.
It real, just like Roe, will be a social experiment conducted, really untested, unresearched on the entire country. You know, they're the social implications of this kind of case is so reminiscent of Roe v. Wade.
Critics of same-sex marriage warn that legalizing it means one harmful effect will be on religious liberty, something that's already been seen with government bludgeoning believers at businesses that refuse to back gay marriages.
As society redefines marriage, it then starts to violate religious liberty rights. We've seen bakers and florists and photographers who have no problem serving gay and lesbian customers who only object to helping to celebrate a same-sex wedding. They've been harassed by the government. They've been penalized by the government, coerced by the government.
Rarely do we come to a moment like this, where the course of a nation, a society, a culture is all hanging on 2.5 hours in a courtroom. Paul Strand, CBN News, Washington.